I was looking for cost efficiencies, sustainability. I was looking to allow the business to continuously run. I was looking for quickness of turnaround, no interruption to the business. The UPS actually gave me a head start for that. The technology part was, this is a 15-year-old building, and so therefore the infrastructure that we had was clearly coming to the end of its life cycle. So as a requirement to bring it into the 21st century, it was looked at that really this needed to happen. Clearly from an IT perspective, they are under specific pressures, and so therefore best practice, best guidance, we looked for that. So technology was an issue, but it wasn't the whole thing.
We brought to this a lot of our experience in the past about the distribution systems, flexibility and how they could plug things up, which they adopted.
Well, we want to be in a position to actually sustain the business. Clearly, if anything was to go wrong here, we would be in trouble very quickly, and from a business perspective, that cannot be allowed to happen.
Our approach basically was we had to make this place secure even during the construction period.
That's where UPS come into it. They give us that breadth of, if you like, dimension to allow us to carry on our business. UPS was actually a requirement. They came with a high recommendation, and once sitting down with UPS, they effectively became very quickly the people we wanted to deal with.
You look at what the implication is, how will that affect the business, how will it affect the supplies, and you tailor things to work around that. And sometimes that means putting in a whole new distribution, as we've done here.
But the modular system is ideal for my operation. I can actually pull something out, do what I've got to do in it, put it back in again, and effectively we don't interrupt the business. So from that standpoint, it's an economic thing and it's a sustainable thing. Whilst every project has its edges to take care of, I think that this one went really well.